And happy lunch hour, Western Oklahoma. Welcome to BigElkTV.com. It's the Elk City Fast Pitch Festival just about to get underway with the first games of the day. It's going to be the Elk City Elkettes and the Texhoma Red Devils. Aaron Kalk, Jared Atha here at the beautiful facility here at the Fiveplex at Elk City. A brand new scoreboard in down the right field line. Had to switch the team names as Elk City will be first at bat. They'll be the away team here this afternoon. Leading off playing shortstop will be Ellis Attili. Hitting second playing second base is senior Riley Wyatt. The catcher, senior Abby Robbins, will be third if anybody reaches. Brianna Butler, will be in the hole. The pitcher in the circle for the Lady Red Devils is Charlie Thrasher. Her battery made at catchers. Gracie Langford playing first is Caden Kimball. The second baseman is Kennedy Elliott. Third baseman Aspen Collins. Abby Ortega is the shortstop. Around left to right, Blakely Scott in left field. The center fielder is Jackie Berry. Right fielder is Cody Audrain. As Ellis Attili gets things started with a hot shot right at the middle, a single, and the Elk City Elkettes fast pitch season is underway, Jared.
Well, that's any indication on how this season's going to go. It's going to be a really good season. A lot of anticipation for this year's squad, this fall's squad. Bringing back a lot of great players, adding some really good players, and they're really solid this year. Another first pitch attack.
Riley Wyatt grounded it, kind of chopped it to the shortstop. Up with it was Ortega. Elliott wasn't quite to the bag yet, so sliding in safely on the fielder's choice at second to Satilli. Riley Wyatt reaches first base on the fielder's choice. That'll bring up Abby Robbins, the catcher, senior for the Elkettes. Runners on first and second. Nobody out here in the top of the first inning of the Elk City softball season. First pitch from Thrasher, called strike one. This is an interesting angle right here behind the plate. You can see the way the ball moves.
Yes, it is.
Up and down, left and right.
And we're going to see a lot of good pitches, I think, from both sides today, especially for the Big Elks. Here's one put out the right.
A little flare down the right field line, in and out of the glove of the right fielder, Audrain. Coming around third, safely home is going to be Ellis Attili, and Abby Joe Robbins has an RBI double, and the Elk City Elkettes lead 1-0 with runners on second and third and nobody out.
Well, my motto has always been, you put the ball in play, good things are going to happen more often than not. I mean, credit the bats for the big or the Elkettes, although that was an error.
Yeah, it looked like she kind of sliced it down the right field line.
Kind of tailed on her.
Kept on getting further away from Audrain.
Wind's blowing out from where we're sitting, from the south, going to the north. Like to see if, I mean, the Big Elks, their power, or their attacking early in the count, which is very evident. I'd like to see how much power they can put behind it, use this wind to their advantage.
And the wind, if you're looking on there on BigElkTV.com, blowing straight toward the scoreboard across the diamond left to right almost. Brianna Butler in there with runners on second and third. Nobody out, 1-0 Elk City. First pitch called strike one. Thrasher's pounded the strike zone. The Elkettes put the ball in play. A couple of misplays have led to the first run for Elk City.
It's good eyes. She saw that immediately come out of her hands, telling away from her.
The 0-1 just outside. Our man Frank Mendez behind the plate calling balls and strikes this morning. Her ball catches the outside corner. 1-2 is Thrasher working ahead here of the cleanup hitter, Brianna Butler. Aubrey Pogue, freshman pitcher, will be next.
I believe that was the same pitch. This time just grazed the outside.
Would you call that a rise ball?
That's
there?
Definitely a rise ball.
Butler laid off. Evens count 2-2.
This scoreboard, maybe later in the game, we'll point the camera at it. It is fantastic. First thing I noticed pulling in the parking lot.
Butler slashes it out of play, foul. Staying alive at 2-2. RBI double from Robbins. Single from Satilli, a grounder, fielder's choice from Riley Wyatt. Riley stands on third. Abby Joe's at second with nobody out. Top of the first inning. Butler at the plate with the runners on second and third. Nice job behind the dish there by Lankford to keep that in front of her, but it is a full count.
I don't know, not a lot of teams get to play on turf. But after, shoot, an inning and a half, you already know how it's going to bounce. You're used to it. She knew exactly where that was going to go. It was a good job by the catcher.
Full count in the dirt. So Butler coaxes the walk to load the bases for freshman Aubrey Pogue. Pogue will be the pitcher on defense. Her first career at bat in varsity softball with the bases loaded. Nobody out in the top of the first. Elk City already up 1-0 against Texhoma.
We talk about a lot of the returning seniors on this team, but there's the additions. She's one of them that's putting a lot of excitement in this year, the potential for this year for the Elkettes.
First pitch in the dirt for ball one. Jada Kimball, the left fielder, standing in the on-deck circle. A 1-0 high and away, ball two.
Mentioned the breeze. I think I'm trying to speak it into existence for the rest of the day. Without this breeze, it would be warm.
Keep the cloud cover.
Keep the nice overcast we got going on. And the nice breeze, nothing too windy.
2-0 line drive over the second baseman's head. It falls into right field. Pogue with an RBI single.
Pretty close.
Around third is Robbins. It's not Robbins. That's Maddox. Isaiah Maddox was the courtesy runner for Abby Joe. She scores as well. So another RBI double, this time from the freshman Aubrey Pogue, a two-run double. Elk City's up 3-0. Runners on second and third, nobody out. Jada Kimball at the plate. Jada rips one into left field, down in front of Scott. And Brianna Butler, BB, touches the plate. RBI single for Jada Kimball, jumping out on the first pitch, and the Elk City Elkhead bats are smoking here to start. 4-0 in the top of the first with runners on the corners, nobody out. That brings up sophomore J.C. Baker, another addition via the transfer. She comes down from Hammond.
Loving the aggressiveness from the Elkettes.
The pitch gets away from the catcher over Langford's head. Cruising in to score is Pogue. And the Elkettes have put a 5-spot on the board, advancing to second on the wild pitch was Jada Kimball. Runner on second, nobody out. Baker facing a 1-0 count with Kimball standing on second base. A dream start to the first game of the year for the Elk City Elkettes.
Could be a quick first game at this rate.
Second pitch rises high for ball two. Senior Jill Metter, the right fielder, awaits in the on-deck circle. Pitch to Baker, high and away for ball three.
Texhoma, I believe, the co-op with Goodwill.
Yeah, Texhoma Goodwill, that's correct.
You ever been to Texhoma?
I have not. Been to Guymon.
Been to Texhoma. Called a football game there. Did not know it till I got there. Half that town is in Texas.
Is it really?
Yeah. Other half is in Oklahoma. The school system, obviously the school itself, is in the Oklahoma side. It's an interesting town.
3-1 off-speed pitch. Had Baker out in front. So it's full count to J.C. Baker with the runner on second. Nobody out here in the top of the first. The Elkettes up 5-0. I know a person from Texhoma.
Do you?
Yes. Cassie Matlock. Brett's wife. Cassie Worley was her maiden name. As Baker chops it to the shortstop. Out at first, firing across the diamond was Kimball. But Jada Kimball beats the throw to third.
Well, move the runner.
Of Caden Kimball. Kimball trying to get Kimball out. Yeah, fielder's choice there for Baker. Moves the runner to third with one out. And brings up Jill Metter, the senior for the Elkettes.
I mean, even when getting out, they're still productive. That's what you like to see if you're a coach and you're an Elkett fan.
Better. First one high, ball one. Yeah, so I guess if they'd have built the school on the other side of the line, they'd be a Texas school.
I'm not sure how that works, and you know a lot of those kids, I'm sure, live on the Texas side.
Do you have to get an out-of-state transfer?
I'm not sure how it works. I know, obviously, the school district kind of creeps in there, and it made me think what other towns that are kind of border towns that are like that.
2-0 to Metter, gets away from the catcher Langford, safely at home is Jada Kimball. Give Jill an RBI for standing there.
Almost dangerous. It hit the – you could hear it, too. It hit the concrete backing, not the net itself. And it kind of popped back, but the pitcher wasn't hustling down to try to cover.
Ball three. So 3-0 count here to Jill Metter. Nobody out. Or one out, excuse me. Nobody on base. The Elkettes put six on the board here in the top of the first. And Jill Metter will head down to first base via the base on balls. Brings up Madison Holiday. Just the first lefty?
It is. Lineup? It is.
Madison playing shortstop. Emily Lawrence is being DH for. She'll be the third baseman when the Elkettes hit the field. Oak City's batted around with Satilli standing over there on deck. First pitch to Holiday, a little high for ball one.
Good eye. Need lower and in. I think it was where it needed to be as far as inside, just a little high. Hey, real quick, thanks to Anadarko Dozer and Trucking, Jay and Angie Wyatt, Oklahoma's leading dirt and trucking company, helping us out with our broadcast.
Runner goes. Metter trying to steal second, and Jill slides in safely to throw a little high.
Man, catcher delayed on the throw, too. I don't think her counterpart was over there, or either one of them were. They both kind of converged. Some confusion on defense early in this one for Texhoma.
Yeah, first game of the year. You can kind of see a little bit of problems. Our man Carl Lawrence is in the house right over here to our left.
Good crowd today.
Yes, it is. 2-0. Outside ball three to Holiday. Metter stands on second. Back to the top of the lineup, and Ella Satilli in the on-deck circle. The Elkettes are up 6-0, as you can see there on the scoreboard. Holiday watches the 3-0 down the middle. It's 3-1. Thrasher's done a good job throwing strikes.
This Elk City's just done a better job hitting them.
Yeah. 3-1 slashed foul. If I was Ella, I'd come to the other side. Looks like Madison, one of the first kind of slap-looking style hitters, which makes sense. The only lefty in the lineup.
Yeah, get quick out of that box.
She can fly, too, I'm pretty
sure. Third placement's playing really close, too. She's expecting something like that.
The payoff pitch. Slashed it down just foul. Collins. The third baseman, it was out of her reach, but just enough spin, kind of cut spin on it. Coach Murray not willing to make a play over there. So we'll do it again, 3-2 to Holiday. Runner on second and one out here in the top of the first inning. The Elkettes lead 6-0. Holiday waves. I thought she ticked it.
He's going to say got just enough, just tapped it. That was an off-speed pitch. You saw way behind she was. She tried to slow down her swing. This is a good at-bat if she can get on here somehow.
Yeah, good job by both players. It was 3-0. Thrasher came back and threw some strikes, and now Holiday's fought a couple of pitches off to see another one. Here's the 3-2. High and away. So a second straight base on balls issued by Thrasher after none for the first eight hitters. Back to the top of the lineup we come. With Ella Satilli, she ripped one right past the shortstop on the first pitch of the game. Came around and scored on an RBI from Robbins. She stays in with runners on first and second. It's Metter on second, Holiday at first. Shortstop, Birdie Satilli at the plate. And she hammers one through the hole on the right side into right field. Coming around third is Metter. Jill will score easily. And Ella Satilli's got her second single of the first inning. This one carries an RBI with it. The Elkettes lead 7-0. Over Texhoma, advancing to third on the base hit was Madison Holiday.
Still only one away, and nightmare start if you're a Red Devil out there.
Riley
Wyatt. Especially getting back to the top of the lineup.
Yeah, Wyatt stands in. Hit a chopper to the shortstop for a fielder's choice in her first at bat. Came around and scored on the Aubrey Pogue double. Riley, pop up to the second baseman. Kennedy Elliott is underneath it, makes the play for the second out of the inning. We'll bring up Abby Robbins. Heads up from the other field. Going to need somebody to
rethink our position here. We're kind of vulnerable. Not so much us, but our equipment.
Foul ball from the other field. Who's playing over there? Minko and Granite, I think.
Minko and... Well, we do have a schedule.
Minko and Lakiba.
Lakiba.
Playing over here. We'll give you the rundown of the schedule for the day.
Some good representation of local schools at this festival.
Yeah, some local and some away.
And some away. I like the nice mix there.
Robbins, fly ball into center field. Back to the wall. It is off the wall. Barry couldn't make the play. Rounding third, coming to score is Satilli. Abby Joe's going to slide in safely with an RBI two-run triple. And the Elkettes lead 9-0 over the Texhoma Lady Devils. It's Brianna Butler next. First pitch, just low for ball one. One out to Butler, knocked down by Langford, the catcher, keeping it in front of her. Butler slashes it toward the right fielder, charging and making the play is Audrain for the final out of the inning. But not before, the Elk City Elkettes scored 9 runs on 7 hits, 1 left on base. We go to the bottom of the second inning, or the bottom of the first inning. Elk City leads Texhoma 9-0. This is Elk City Softball on BigElkTV.com.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use, dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the companies run, with clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees, and commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Welcome back to Elk City Softball right here on BigElkTV.com. The Elk City Elkettes put 9 on the board in the top of the first to lead Texhoma 9-0. Aubrey Pogue, the freshman, will be in the circle for Elk City here this morning. Her battery mate is senior Abby Robbins. Brianna Butler will play first. Riley Wyatt second. The third baseman is Emily Lawrence. Shortstop Ella Satilli. In the outfield, you'll have Kimball Holiday and Jill Metter going left to right across the outfield. Pogue, the freshman, with her first appearance here as a varsity pitcher for Elk City. It'll be Jackie Berry, center fielder, hitting first. Gracie Langford, the catcher, is second. Caden Kimball, the first baseman, will hit third. Jackie Berry standing in. First pitch from Pope. High for ball one. Aubrey's second pitch in there. Strike one, even in the count at 1-1. It'll be Berry, Langford, and Kimball. The three due up here in the bottom of the first for Texhoma. Bunt attempt down the first baseline.
Oh.
Butler touches it fair. They had no chance to get Berry, the speedy Berry at first. Probably had to hope that one would go foul.
Well,
instead, Brianna touched it, and it's a leadoff single for Jackie Berry.
It looked like it was going to – it had that spin. I thought it was going to roll foul, but – there's always that chance it just hangs on there and she could be running for days while you're waiting for it to continue to roll foul. I don't blame her for making the attempt.
They'll bring up Gracie Langford, the catcher. First pitch called strike one.
For those wondering, because I was one of them wondering what the run rule is, as you can see, Elk up 9-0. It's 12 after 3, 10 after 4, and 8 after 5. Hopefully you'll see a lot of those this year.
You get 9 in the first, you got a chance.
You got a heck of a chance.
Any game. The 1-1 from Pogue, runner goes. Robbins throw.
Got her
at second. Perfect strike from Abby Joe. Ella Satilli making the play. There the tag is. Abby Joe turned around and smiled with the cannon there. So he erased the runner, Barry. It's a 2-1 count to the catcher, Langford, with one. Nobody on and one out here in the bottom of the first inning.
That was perfect execution.
Ball's hit high into right field. Metter in foul territory. Can't make the play in and out of her glove. She got there, almost overran it just a tick.
Well, it's just so odd. You get that ball up there in that jet stream, if you will. And that, just like the first inning, you saw it tailing, and she had a shot at it. And you're right, I think she did over-pursue a little bit, hit off her palm.
Yeah, the wind's almost from foul pole to foul pole, left field to toward the scoreboard. And you can see anything hit in the air to right field's tailing toward the line. Thankfully, though, it was out of bounds. It's her ball, or out of bounds. Foul ball. Curveball freezes Langford for the first strike out of the career for Aubrey Pogue on the inside corner. Two away, nobody out. That'll bring up the first baseman, Caden Kimball, for Texhoma.
My view is a little obstructed. I couldn't see what kind of spin it had on it, but it definitely froze her. She thought it was going to stay inside, and right at the last second, it broke in.
First pitch to Kimball, high and away for ball one. Second stays a bit high as well from Pope. So 2-0 count to the first baseman, Caden Kimball, for Texhoma. Nobody on, two out. Bottom of the first inning, the Elkettes leading 9-0. I keep up looking at the new scoreboard over here in right field, and I see that 53. I think it's the batter's number. Turns out it's the time.
They do have a time limit. That's right. 75 minutes.
Yes. So a running time clock.
That's interesting. That's convenient,
festival.
Too. You don't have to worry about – I mean, that could be the official clock. I'm sure the official has one, too, but it gives everyone a good idea where we're at.
3-1, slashed foul. Nice almost play by the first base coach down the line for Texhoma. Knocked it down, at least.
Scoreboard does everything.
Yeah, it does.
I mean, everything. I love it.
So that fills the count to Kimball. Pogue's payoff pitch is hit in the hole between first and second. Nice job by Kimball going with that pitch.
Butler was kind of cheating over to first. She had her momentum going towards the foul line to base, and she was not able to get her feet back to get over there to field it. If she had stayed right where she was at, that was an easy out.
One more right here.
That will bring up Charlie Thrasher, the pitcher. First pitch to Thrasher, catches the outside corner, strike one.
We're going to catch. That was great framework right there by Robbins. Caught it and held it there just enough to get the call.
The second single of the first inning for Texhoma. The first hitter was gunned down by Abby Joe at second trying to steal. That was Jackie Berry. 0-1 is fouled out right, almost hit me in the knee. Got some give to the net.
You do forget that the net has a little bit more give.
Got some give. So it's 0-2 count for the runner on first and two out in the bottom of the first for Texhoma. Tried to get her to chase the rise ball. Thrasher wouldn't do it. Evens the count at 2-2.
I just got to learn my phone. The possible rain, although it says I'm in Canute. I'm not. But there are some rain clouds around.
2-2. Swung on a miss. Strike three. Texhoma puts up no runs on two hits. No errors, one left on base. We head to the top of the second inning. The Elkettes lead Texhoma 9-0. It's Elk City Softball on BigElkTV.com.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quint Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. Gene Smith, of course, has been here his whole life. He's a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Two up here in the top of the second inning for the Elk City Elkettes. It'll be the 5, 6, and 7 holes. Aubrey Pogue, Jay DeKimble, J.C. Baker. Elk City put a 9 spot on the board in the top of the first. They lead the Red Devils of Texhoma 9-0. Baker. 0-for-1 with a fielder's choice to the third baseman back in the first inning. Kimball had an RBI single. Pogue with a 2-run double in her only at bat. Then Aubrey went out on the in the center in the pitcher circle, gave up a couple of singles, struck out 2, was able to wiggle off the hook with no runs allowed. Now she'll stand in to lead off the second inning. Thrasher still in the circle for Texhoma. The first pitch is low. Second inning's underway with ball 1. Thinking of Snap-on Tools, Levi Cook. Snap-on makes work easier for professionals performing critical tasks. Snap-on Tools. Pogue, soft line drive right at the second baseman. Elliott makes the play for the out for the first out of the inning. That brings up Jada Kimball. Senior left fielder hit a smash over the shortstop's head for an RBI single back in the first. First pitch up and away for ball 1. Kimball lifts it into right field. Charging it is Drain. Can't make the play. It spins away from her. Jada around first to second. Rounding second. Digging for third. She's going to have a stand-up triple with one out in the bottom of the, or the top of the second inning. Man, that wind and the spin off of those kind of off the end of the bats to right field has been playing havoc for both sides. That one just spun away from Audrain into the corner.
And then the bounce, that's back to that turf I was talking about. It takes a little some getting used to. It's not going to just flop on the ground on natural turf, on natural grass. There's bounce out there. And she kind of misplayed it there too.
Yeah, just spun right away from her. Brings up J.C. Baker with a runner on third and one out. Baker grounded into a fielder's choice, her only at-bat so far. This one is looped over the third baseman set. It's an RBI single for the sophomore J.C. Baker, and the Elkettes have put up 10 in the first couple of innings. 10-0 with runner on first, one out. Jill Metter at the plate. Jill walked, stole a base, and scored back in the first.
I'll say this, if you're taking your lunch break right now, you might want to hurry up. This game might be over in a hurry.
Get on out here to the fiveplex.
There's going to be other great games, though. We'll cover that in a little bit.
Metter in the hole between short and third, up with it and making the play to second base. Nice job there by Ortega.
It was close.
Abby Ortega makes the play, cutting down Baker. 6-4 for the second out. Metter on first on the fielder's choice. That'll bring up Madison Holiday. She walked and scored back in the first inning. Metter stands on first base with two out. Holiday at the plate. If she can reach back to the top of the lineup, and Ellis Attili, who's 2-for-2 with 2 singles and an RBI.
Real quick, thank you to Barber Dyson Ford, Bruce Barber, David and Corbin Dyson. Experience the difference. Back to school is coming up, what, this week, right?
Yeah, Thursday.
Yeah. No.
Meet the teacher. Open house tonight at the intermediate school, I know for sure.
Is that tonight?
It is
tomorrow
tonight.
For my kiddos. I know they're anxious. Well, I know one's anxious.
1-1 to Madison Holiday. She waves at it for strike 2.
An excuse me swing. She didn't want to about halfway through. Again, third baseman playing up. Really love to see some kind of a slap situation. Not sure how much they practice that. That is an advanced skill.
1-2 is slapped toward the third base, but foul. There's Coach Murray making a play from the coach's box. We chided him in the first inning for not trying that time. He bobbled it, but he stayed with it, and a nice strike back to the pitcher.
Hey, listen, the way these girls can hit.
I get out of the way.
If I don't have a glove, I'm getting out of the way. I'm not about to break a few blood vessels in my palm.
Hey, don't go Denny Gino. You should see the strawberry on his leg from the grudge match number two.
I'm looking for him. See here?
He sent it to me. I'll show you. Hopefully that's the only loss the Selkett team suffers all year is to their parents.
That's true.
The 1-2 to Madison Holiday. Skips in there. Metter's going to be safe at second base.
It's a good effort right there by the catch. Able to field it off the hop and still give an attempt.
Yeah, when Metter took off and the ball in the dirt, I thought she was going to be in there easily, and nice job there.
It was closer
from
than expected.
Yeah. Fire it down there. 2-2 to Holiday. She stays alive.
Hello.
Good job by Madison fighting off pitches, staying alive in this at-bat.
Very reminiscent to her last at-bat.
Fell behind 0-2. Or no, she got ahead 3-0.
She got ahead.
She fouled off a couple of 3-2 pitches before she's able to walk. That's exactly right. And does it again. Just barely got a piece of that one. It's got to be frustrating if you're Thrasher throwing good pitch after good pitch, and she's just kind of fighting it off and making you do it again.
Yeah, it's a cat and mouse type game, you versus her. And you're right, it's frustrating.
This one slapped over the second baseman's head. Base hit, rounding third is Metter. Charging toward the plate, Jill's going to score, so an RBI single for Madison Holiday. It's 11-0 Elkettes, and as you mentioned, 12 after 3 is the run rule. So the Elkettes, one run away from having that at least in play. Holiday at first. They're kind of checking on her. She seems okay.
Got the thumbs up.
Birdie Satilli stands in there 2-for-2 with two hard hit singles. First pitch, away ball one.
Tell you what, Aaron, those hats that the coaches are wearing, Jordan Brand Elk City hats.
Hunt.
We're going to need a couple of those before football season. What do you say?
I like it. This one's ripped into right field, right at the right fielder, jumping up and making the catch is on drain. Hard hit line drive.
Oh, misread that one.
So Tilly hit it hard, but right at on drain. Elkettes put two more runs on the board. Two runs on three hits. No errors. One left on base. We head to the bottom of the second inning. Elk City up 11-0. It's Elk City softball right here on BigElkTV.com.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space, and we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Welcome back. Elkettes softball right here on BigElkTV.com. We reached the bottom of the second. Elk City leads Texhoma 11-0. Up for Texhoma here in the home half of the second. It'll be Abby Ortega, Aspen Collins, and Cody Audrain to face the freshman, Aubrey Pogue. Thanks to Justin Twyman of Tips Agency, service you deserve from your insurance agent. That's Justin Twyman at Tips, and I can promise you that's the truth. I had his cell phone number, but he'll even give you his cell phone number. You can call him anytime you like there at Tips Agency. So the shortstop Ortega in there. First pitch from Pogue, a little high ball one.
Also, thank you to Moxie Realty. Just heard from her, Amy Robbins. Moxie makes it happen.
See her right over there to our left.
Let's get a lot of these live reads in because it might be a quick game.
The 1-0 from Pogue.
Heads up.
Slashed foul. Heads up to the Weatherford Lady Eagles walking in. They were paying attention. Maybe some.
A lot of them have gloves on, too. That's, yeah, if you want to hit it towards a crowd, make sure they got gloves on.
Maybe the Trojanettes as well making their way in. Seeing J-Dub over there.
See Gillette. The black and gold.
1-1. Low ball, two. Frank made the play. It hit his foot instead of Abby Joe's glove. So we got two games going on right now. Obviously, this one, and Minko and Lakiba are playing. Then at 1 o'clock, all three fields. It'll be this Texhoma team will take on Canute. On field one, you've got Minko and Hammond. And then Weatherford Arnett will be right here on this field. 2:30, Weatherford and Mangum, Lakiba and Clinton, Hammond and Fargo. At 4 o'clock, Canute will play Visai. Clinton will play Arnett. Shattuck and Chickasha will do battle. Then at 5:30, the nightcap. Mangum and Visai, Shattuck and Fargo, and your Elk City Elkettes will be back in action against Chickasha. 3-1 count to Ortega. Dribbles it to the second baseman, Riley Wyatt. Riley's up with it, makes the play to the first out of the inning.
Almost cost her. She kind of waited on it. That was kind of a slow roller. I always teach them young to attack that ball, go get it. She was fast. She was hustling down.
It's wild to see when the ball's not hit solidly, with all the spin that the pitchers put on it, how much it moves. Mm-hmm. You know, like that one. I think Riley started to come in and then went, wait a minute, it just shot to my leg. You know,
right.
Like, trying to make sure she knew where it was going. Brings up Aspen Collins. Aspen, the third baseman, watches the first pitch just a bit outside.
Heck of a pitch. Had some wild movement on it.
Yeah, I mean, there's so much more spin from the pitcher than what you're used to in baseball.
Oh, yeah.
That if you don't square it up, it almost creates more of it, especially as we've seen to right field. The right fielders have had all kinds of trouble with the breeze and the spin.
It's always amazed me at this. You know, it's a closer distance, obviously, between the rubber and home plate. But within that distance, how much spin and how much movement that a pitcher can apply to that ball. And it just shows the level of dedication that these young pitchers put in to know how to do that. And it starts at a young age. I'm seeing it now, and it applies all the way up.
Collins fouled the 2-0 back and then takes the 2-1 on the inside corner for strike two. Cody Audrain, the right fielder, is standing in the on-deck circle for Texhoma. The 2-2. Hit into the left center field gap. It's down and to the wall. Kimball chases it up with it quickly. Going to hold Collins to a single, but a smooth shot out there. That was squared up perfectly by Collins. Third hit of the game for Texhoma. They haven't had anybody get past first base.
A little surprised she didn't go for second. Yeah, obviously, it was bobbled out in left center. She was going to get there early, but I think she saw the first attempt and held up. But yeah, being down 11-0, you almost need to be ultra aggressive if you're Texhoma.
Yeah, but you also need base runners.
Well, speaking
all
of which, we got a pinch runner coming in.
Uh-oh.
23.
Got that here. Audrain in there, the right fielder, Cody Audrain. 23. That is Wester. E. Wester. First pitch, Audrain. Outside ball one.
Just joining us, Elk City started hot. First inning, 9 runs. Tagged a couple more on. Here's an attempt over at first. Lead 11-0. Is this Texhoma's first base runner, or was that their first hit?
No, they had 2 hits in the first.
You're right.
One caught stealing.
Just feels like nothing's working for Texhoma. Well, that's mainly because of the Elk City offense and defense.
3-0 count here to Audrain. Blakely Scott, the left fielder, is standing on deck.
That's a close one. Murray coming out asking where was that at.
I don't know what to say.
Well, it might be a good time to remind everybody there's new rules the OSSA has released.
All right, runners on first and second as Audrain coaches the 4-pitch walk. There's one in there for a strike. Blakely Scott, the left fielder, stands in. First base runner that's reached to second in the first couple of innings for Texhoma.
Expecting bunt here. Elkettes are.
Yeah, ELO, Emily Lawrence.
Look at her hands.
Is close down the third base line. Scott waves at the 0-1 for strike two.
Odd way to hold the bat. Look at her top hand, almost not at a grip, just kind of up there. And that's what tells me I expect her to immediately bring it down to bunt.
Yeah, it's a split grip.
It is.
Scott waves at the 0-2. Third punch out of the game for Pogue, and that brings up second baseman Kennedy Elliott. If she could reach, leadoff hitter Jackie Berry is next. Two on, two out for Texhoma. First pitch to Elliott. Low and in, ball one.
So Hammond Lady Warriors in the house.
The 1-0 swung over the top of by Elliott. Even in the count at 1-1. A drain at first. Collins stands on second base with two out for Texhoma. 1-1. Right by her for strike two. Pogue trying to wiggle off the hook here in the bottom of the second. The 1-2. Low. Good job by Robbins. Biting it up, keeping it in front of her. It's 2-2 to the nine-hole hitter, Kennedy Elliott.
Big out right here. Two outs. You got two on. Nine-hole hitter towards the bottom of your lineup.
2-2. Low and in. Filling the count. So now the runners will be able to get on the move as soon as the ball is released from Pogue on the 3-2 count with two outs. That could be an advantage. Get one into the outfield, maybe score a run. 3-2, chop foul. We'll do it again. Sure enough, my goodness. Wester was standing on third base when that ball hit the net. She got such a good jump. 3-2, struck her out. Rise ball gets Elliott to chase. For the second straight inning, Aubrey Pogue sits down two. No runs on a hit, a walk, no errors, two left on base. We head to the top of the third with the Elk City Elkettes leading the Texhoma Lady Red Devils 11-0. Elkette softball, BigElkTV.com.
Paragon Sports welcomes State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino and his family to Elk City. And he's proud to support this area's schools, students, and their activities. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. With surprisingly great rates for auto coverage and surprisingly great rates for everyone.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino in Elk City today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Up here in the top of the third for the Elk City Elkettes would be Riley Wyatt, Abby Robbins, and Brianna Butler. 2-3-4. Elkettes lead 11-0. Need one to at least activate the run rule. Of course, they would have to go out and hang a zero at 12-0. 12 after 3, 10 after 4, 8 after 5 are the run rules here at the Elk City Fast Pitch Festival. Nobody's running the scoreboard on that other fielder. I could maybe try to get you an update for Minko and Lokiba. And we get three fields underway at the end of this one at 1 o'clock. And then it just sprint to the finish tomorrow at 4 tomorrow afternoon. Wyatt stands in 0-for-2. She had a fielder's choice in the first inning. Lined out to the second baseman in the second. Ripped it up the middle. I was just about to say, but you know what? I'm not worried about Riley Wyatt in hitting. She'll be just fine. Her first hit of the year almost took off Thrasher's right leg. She stands on first, and that brings up Abby Jo. Robbins, RBI double, two-run triple to her credit here this morning. First pitch on the inside corner for strike one.
It was there, but it was their last inning, too, when not called. But
yeah.
That's the game for you, though.
Off-speed pitch. Robbins watches it sail high for 1-1. She may hit one out.
Making the call?
She might do it.
Well, they're going to pitch around her. They're definitely not going to give her a shot.
1-1 inside. 2-1.
This is your hitter's count. I've always loved a 3-1. It's a different sport, baseball, softball, but you're looking for it here.
She wanted
She wanted to pull the trigger.
Yeah,
she did. It just rose too high for her.
So a walk to Robbins. She stands on first. Wyatt's at second. That brings up Brianna Butler. Brianna scored in the first inning on a single. Flied out to the right fielder.
Like
in a second.
Maddox, I'm going to say it wrong. Help me out.
Asia.
Asia Maddox coming in to run.
That's right. 00. Courtesy runner for the catcher.
We got the time. Thank you to State Farm Insurance. Our man Daniel Garbarino, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
All softball games will be on BigElkTV.com. Sounds like our man Tyrell Suter, Jay Wyatt, be normally with the crew on the call most times.
Look at this delay steal.
Delay steal to third as Wyatt slides in safely, following her up to second base is Maddox.
That was smart. She saw the high pitch. Catcher able to contain it. And she froze right there. And as soon as the pitcher turned around, she went.
Butler rips it into center field. It's going to be caught out there, but tagging up and scoring as Barry makes a nice play on that line drive. A good base running from Wyatt. She tags up and scores.
Now the
check second.
Did they call her out? They called her out. They said she did not tag up in
time. They're going to say Asia Maddox left early. They're going to say Asia left early tagging up. So the run does count. It's 12-0. But that clears the bases for Aubrey Pogue. Two-run double and lined out to the second baseman in her two plate appearances. I was watching Riley to make sure she didn't leave early.
Well,
she didn't from third scoring.
I will say this. It over at second, it caught my peripherals, and yeah. I thought, man, did she leave early? I didn't want to say it out loud and speak it to existence, but you know, good call for Texhoma at least to check it. You never know.
Well, you know, in a situation like this where that run at third means there's a chance at a run rule,
mm-hmm.
everybody's is so focused on third base that good job
right.
by the coaching staff that, or yeah. one of them to be watching second. Because I certainly was, and I was watching. I could see perfectly with Riley and the center fielder, Jackie Berry. Pogue hits it into center field. Berry back to the wall. She reaches up and makes the play. Hard hit ball to center field. But that will do it. The Elkettes do put a run on the board on a hit, a walk. Nobody left on base. We head to the bottom of the third. Chance at a run rule here in game one of the season for the Elk City Elkettes. They're leading 12-0 over Texhoma. It's Elkette softball right here on BigElkTV.com.
If your garage door looks like this, there's only one person to call. Red Dirt Garage Doors. They'll literally get you back on track and rolling up and down again. Red Dirt Garage Door does residential and commercial sales and service serving Southwest Oklahoma and the Texas Panhandle. You can call for a free estimate at 580-482-6369. That's 580-482-6369. Red Dirt Garage Doors, keeping you on track and the garage door looking good.
Bottom of the third inning, Texhoma has to have one to stay. Top of the lineup, Barry, Langford, and Kimball, if anybody reaches. Thrasher would be next. Jackie Berry singled on a bunt in the first inning, was caught down by the catcher Robbins trying to steal second. Pogue's gone the entire way for the Elkettes. Giving up three hits, walked one, struck out four. in her first appearance. Freshman pitcher for the Elkettes. First one right in there, strike one.
Shout out to Mike Adams at Red Dirt Garage Doors, the garage door nerd. And I'm not calling him a nerd, it just says that right there on the pitch sheet.
No one to bury, just a little low, even in the count at 1-1.
There's nothing more frustrating than a busted garage door.
Oh, I know. Isn't that the case? Isn't
so
that the truth? Golly. 1-1. Popped up. Robbins has the play from the catcher position. Nice job by Abby Jo. Sprinting out of there to get herself in perfect position for the first out of the inning. Bring up Gracie Langford. She struck out looking back in the first.
Didn't think she saw it. She kind of looked up and took a couple steps, found it.
Langford lifts it into short right field. Riley Wyatt takes a couple of steps back, makes the play for out number two, and the Elkettes are one out away from a run rule victory here in game one of the season, game one of the Elk City Fast Pitch Festival. Caden Kimball stands in. She hit a clean single back in the first. First pitch catches the inside corner for strike one. There was a lot of anticipation, a lot of excitement for this team. And so far, so good for the Elkettes. You see a good mix, being able to hit the softball. Pogue doing a pretty good job in her first. You would assume probably a little bit of nerves, maybe a little bit of nerves.
Sure.
But if this is her nervy performance, look out.
I've never seen a foul ball hit the top crossbar of the backstop like that.
1-2 to Kimball. Nobody on, two out in the bottom of their third inning. Elkettes looking to run rule Texhoma with the last out. Smoked it to the first baseman, but Brianna Butler's right there to catch the line drive. And that will do it. No runs on no hits, no errors, nobody left on base. The Elk City Elkettes knock off the Texhoma Lady Devils by a score of 12-0 in the three-inning run rule. We want to take a break, come back, finish up with stats. Tell you what's going to be going on all day long right here at the Elk City Fast Pitch Festival on BigElkTV.com.
Insurance Agency is an independent insurance agency. Justin Twyman, what does that mean?
Well, Sean, that means that we can go out and shop multiple carriers. We're not tied to one line of business. That way, if one line of business declines you, we have another line of business to come in and quote. Tips Agency, we currently represent a little over 100 carriers. So we have an outlet for your insurance needs.
What's the best way to contact you at the Tips Agency?
You can stop by my office, 314 North Main Street, just north of Walgreens. Or you can call my cell phone. Cell phone number is 580-374-1052.
Welcome back to Big Elk TV. It is the first game of the Elk City Elkettes softball season in the books. They win it 12-0 over Texhoma here in the Elk City Festival. First of two games for the Elkettes. They'll play later tonight, or this afternoon, I should say, about 5:30. And we'll have that one covered for you as well. Jared Atha with you right alongside Aaron Kalk, Aaron Skinny Kalk, as he is getting the final stats ready. Gives me time to say thank you to some of our great sponsors. Elk City Summer Softball League, helping build tomorrow's softball leaders. And boy, oh, howdy, are they doing that, as you saw here in this first game of the 2022 fall season, fast pitch season, with a 12-0 dominant performance from the Elk City Elkettes, led by their dynamic freshman pitcher. Also, a big thank you to make sure we got everybody covered. We mentioned Tips Agency, Justin Twyman, the service you deserve from your insurance agent. And thank you to all of our great sponsors helping us out with Elkett Softball, Snap-on Tools, Barber Dyson Ford, Anadarko Dozer and Trucking, Moxie Realty, Red Deer Garage Doors, and State Farm Insurance. Big shout-out to everybody. Aaron, you got those stats ready to go?
I do.
About three innings worth. Yeah, didn't take you that long.
Three innings. Jackie Berry, starting on the Texhoma side. Jackie Berry was 1-for-2. She singled but was caught stealing in the first. 0-for-2 from Gracie Langford. Caden Kimball was 1-for-2 with a single, and she also hit that last one hard to the first baseman, Butler. Thrasher was 0-for-1 with a strikeout. Abby Ortega 0-for-1 with a ground out to second. 1-for-1 for Aspen Collins on a single. 0-for-0 with a walk for Cody Audrain. 0-for-1 for both Blakely Scott and Kennedy Elliott with strikeouts for Texhoma. On the other side for the Elk City Elkettes, Ellie Satilli was 2-for-3 with an RBI, had a couple of singles. 1-for-3 from Riley Wyatt. She singled and stole the base. 2-for-2 for Abby Joe on a double and a triple. She had three RBI, also had a throw from the catcher spot, threw out a base runner trying to steal. Butler was 1-for-3 with an RBI, as was Pogue, 1-for-3 with a two-run double. 2-for-2 for Jada Kimball. She knocked in a run, had a single and a triple. J.C. Baker was 1-for-2 with an RBI and a single. 0-for-1 for Jill Metter, but she reached base twice, stole two bases, and knocked one in. Madison Holiday was 1-for-1 with a walk and an RBI. On the hill, Aubrey Pogue, three innings, gave up three hits, four Ks, walked one, and went the distance for her first win in her career as an Elk City Elkette, the first of what figures to be, or hopefully will be many, for the freshman Elk City Elkette. So a great start to the softball season for Elk City. Much promise leading up into this thing. And Jared, man, you can't ask for much more. They came out ready, came out looking like they were totally prepared to have another great season. Ended in regionals last year. To my knowledge, I don't think Elk City's ever made the fast pitch softball state tournament. I'll have to check on that. I was looking, couldn't find that for sure. But this team seems poised to make another long run here in the fall on the softball field.
Yeah, it's, if this game is any indication, I mean, I go back to the first at-bat, and I said it then, it's kind of like starting a round of golf, that first drive, and it really kind of sets the tone for the rest of your round. Well, that first at-bat might have set the tone for the rest of the season and this first game, for that matter. So, very exciting, and see how they look moving forward. And, you know, it's a long season. They're going to take their lumps. Everybody does. But they got the up and down the lineup. I was impressed. They got the defense, the pitching you mentioned. It was a well-rounded game despite it only being three innings. I think we saw a little bit of everything that they can do this season.
Yeah, absolutely. It wasn't just one side. It was both.
Yeah.
And the aggressiveness, like you said. I mean, you want to talk about starting things off on the right foot. The very first pitch was laced into center field by Ellis Attili. And when your leadoff hitter can kind of get things going, hitting's contagious like that.
Yes.
And, man, I mean, just – saw one pitch, ripped it in the center field. Next thing you know, they put up a nine spot in the first.
Right. And you say hitting's contagious, winning's contagious. And the way they can rack up some wins, we saw glimpses of it last fall, even in the slow pitch season. And then now it's – this is – again, I'm going to sound like a broken record, but this is going to be a fun year. And if you're not here, we appreciate our viewers watching. But, man, get out here and you get a chance to watch this team play. Another opportunity today at 5:30.
Yeah, 5:30 against Chickasha, and then the JV will play tomorrow. And then the last varsity game of this Fast Pitch Festival will be tomorrow at 4 o'clock against Visalia, at least for the Elk City Elkettes. Thanks to everybody sponsoring. I think maybe Jay and Tyrell will be here tonight, maybe, or at least maybe learning a little bit.
I've seen he would the knock on, but I'll find it later.
We'll be back 5:30 for Elk City and Chickasha. Thanks for everybody for watching here on Big Elk TV. Have a wonderful rest of your afternoon.
Thank you for tuning in to this presentation of Elk City Athletics, presented by the Bank of Western Oklahoma, where people come first. Big Elk TV and Cool 94 are a part of the Paragon Communications Network, and any distribution or rebroadcast without permission is strictly prohibited. Paragon Communications is owned and operated by Blake Brewer. General Manager is Gabe Edney. Sports Director, Sean Wilson. Once again, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, go Big Elks.